Hi Aries, welcome to Sophquest. Welcome to your weekly reading. This is for the week of October 25th through the 31st. So yeah, ends on Halloween. I don't know about you, but I do love the masquerade, the dress up. Always have. I used to be in plays and things on stage and had so much fun. So I always loved costumes and I enjoy Halloween so much. I am a costume fanatic. All right, so today we are using amazing decks. We're gonna use Alana Fairchild's tarot deck called the Sacred, or Oracle deck called the Sacred Rebels. The artwork is by Autumn Sky Morrison, love. And then my steampunk tarot, this is one of my favorites of all time. It's one of the first three decks that I ever had, and honestly, I learned so much from the book, from Barbara Moore, and I absolutely love and adore the artwork by Ali Fell. I think you'll enjoy these decks today. They feel autumny to me. And I kind of do that with my decks. I have a tendency to do that. So this week, astrologically, we get a bit of a breather after that immense and important full moon, right? Especially for you Aries. It was your full moon. So I'm sure that it was pretty deep and emotional. And it may have felt, I think, liberating, like a big sigh, a letting go and a sigh of relief. Maybe a feeling that your life is about to embark on something new and important, as well as the ability to leave something behind that you needed to, right? That's kind of how it feels, I think. So this week, Venus is doing a couple of things, squaring Neptune. That can be a little idealistic and fantastical and dreamy, but I say enjoy that. It's a great week for music. I mean, really dig into some good music this week. I would do that. But that's on the 26th, Venus square Neptune, kind of romantic, can be very healing. So anything with art and beauty, again, music, is excellent. On the 28th, Venus sextile Jupiter is beautiful, right? Jupiter expands what it touches, Venus there. So this week, you know, you don't want to overindulge, I would say, but it could be a very romantic week, can be very healing. That's nice. And then on the 30th, day before Halloween, that would be Saturday night, we do have Sun square Saturn, which can bring about some seriousness and a feeling of certain limitations, but it can get us very grounded as well, which I think is a good thing after all that Venus action, right? Okay. And Jupiter and Mercury talking about open-mindedness, right? So I like the week. I think it feels good. I think it feels like a little bit of a breather, honestly, an exhale after that full moon. All right, Aries, let's get into it. We're going to pull a couple from the Sacred Rebels. Let's do that now. All right, I've shuffled plenty. Going to cut the deck and pull a few. Wow. Beyond the mind, the heart beats. Interestingly enough, I pulled this card for myself actually yesterday, and I read from the book, and it was so deep and so beautiful. So I might read a little excerpt from that, we'll see. Then we have dream, a beautiful dream. Yeah, this is about allowing your heart to drive and trying to keep the wheels of the mind to, you know, keep them from revving too much. And then thirdly, let's see, visions of life beyond death. So Scorpio season. So Scorpio season, here we are. We're in the first decan, or the first 10 days of Scorpio season. Scorpio is the eighth house of life, death, rebirth, and transformation. And it's one of the more serious houses. It's very deep. It's a water sign house. And it is deeply emotional. But the thing that I think is misunderstood about Scorpio, and the thing that I really love about Scorpio is Scorpio knows deep, intimate love. It's intimacy on the deepest level. It's private, right? It's sacred, a little secret. It's what we don't necessarily share with people, but it's something that touches us very deeply inside. And when we fall in love or we have a great friendship or we're really close to a family member, we come very close to that kind of depth that human love is capable of, that we are capable of going that deep with someone and being that intimate and that close to someone emotionally. It also involves sexuality, so yes, sexual intimacy is included in that house in the sign of Scorpio, but it's also just pure privacy and intimacy on the deepest level. So if you think about that for the next few weeks, you may be very internal, you may be a little deep, you may be a little intense, but I like it. I think it's very sensual. I think, you know, engaging something that really elicits your, you know, and enhances your five senses is a beautiful thing, right? Absolutely. So we have beyond the mind, the heart beats. You know, I always think of the phrase, unto everything there is a season. Scorpio reminds us of that. It helps us to have reverence, to pay reverence for the season that we're in, and for the season that we're leaving behind, and for the season that's coming again. And to know that through those seasons and all those changes, we kind of have to go with it. And this is just saying you don't have to think about life too much that way and analyze it to death and plan it out to death, right? Making God laugh. We know that the seasons come and the seasons go. It is the most natural thing, just like life and death and rebirth is the most natural thing. So this is allowing your heart to sing, really letting your feelings be what they are and completely and wholeheartedly embracing them. Then Dream a Beautiful Dream is about allowing that feeling to lead you. Let your heart guide your feet, okay? Visions of life beyond death. So not worrying about next season necessarily. Let the visions come to you. All right, so now I'm gonna use the beautiful, the fantastic, gorgeous, Steampunk Tarot. All right, two cards have fallen out. Beautiful cards, nice. I'm going to read for you today, horizontally, vertically, and big picture, like always. So if you would just settle in with me, Aries, take a few deep cleansing breaths. Bring down the stress of the day a little bit. Lower the cortisol. That card wants to come out, yep. Lovely. All right, now I'm gonna cut, pull the rest. And see what we see today, all right? We'll jump right in. Beyond the mind, the heart beats. So dream a beautiful dream. Your heart knows what it wants. Visions of life beyond death. Beyond the end of things, there's always a new beginning, right? So it's like if you've had a dream for a while and you just feel like it's just not coming true, understand that your heart knows that it is singing and praying and wishing for it. And your mind is worrying about it, and it's just saying, let your heart send it out there and allow for its season to come when it will, right? We can't control what season it necessarily comes in, especially because we put a lot of limits on the things we wish for, right, as humans. And it can very much end up being something so much greater than we could have ever imagined. In a way, you know, that teaches us something deeper and wider and truer. And in those moments, that's when you really have reverence for life itself and how much it teaches you. Okay, bottom of the deck. You are coming out of a time of fear. And maybe making friends. It's like facing your fear and making friends with it and saying, hey, hey monster. Hey monster. Don't you love that commercial where it says, we have animals in the attic, and then you see animal from the Muppets like playing his drums. Animal. So make friends with that, right? Make friends with what it is that scares you the most. Think about it and make friends with it. That's what I'm seeing here. It's like, I know you're there to protect me. I'm supposed to have fear so that my alarm bell goes off, right? If someone's like following me in the dark when I'm walking down the street and my fear sensors are going off, get away from this person, right? That's natural. But worrying about it and thinking about it and considering what would happen if, well, that's when we get really out of balance. Well, you're coming out of that. You're healing from it with the Four of Swords. The devil in this deck is so fascinating to me because the devil represents our fears, right? And things that keep us obsessed by something that we just repeat in our behavior. So kind of a habit that we repeat a lot. But it's really not actually helping us. It's just a way for us to kind of avoid what we're really afraid of. And this, it's like a giant robot gone wacko, right? And these people have like wrenches and they're trying to like, hold on, I need to fix the robot. The robot's gone mad, right? So our life can become like that. Mechanical. Making us like an automaton. Putting us to sleep. Our mind racing. But about what? About the programming of what the robot part of us is telling us that we have to do. The stress. But beyond the mind, the heart beats. And somewhere when you take rest and respite and you get peace of mind with the Four of Swords, especially at night when you can find your peace of mind, right? You have a dream, you face your fears, you pull out the wrench, you fix the robot, you say, no, I'm coming back to life. I got to get this into balance. Six of Pentacles. I need to weigh this out and really ask myself what they're about. What are my fears about? My worries. When I'm in a state of panic or despair and I can't get myself out of it, what do I do? Well, you look at it and you say, this is not a scary monster. I'm going to be okay. If I put it on the scale and I weigh it out with the good stuff in life, you know, the good stuff is going to end up being the balance I want to focus on. Life is a balance, light and shadow, for sure. So that's what it's kind of telling you. It's like peace of mind or worry, panic, strife, fear. Life is a balance. It doesn't make you, you know, there's nothing wrong with you if you have fears. There's nothing wrong with you if you have moments of despair or even moments of, you know, grief, sadness or anything, anger, rage. These are all human feelings. It's what we do with them that matters. And it's just saying, remember, life is a balance. Scorpio season teaches us that. Unto everything there is a season. A time to live, a time to die. A time to reap, a time to sow. You know, a time for peace, a time for war. It's all in there. Life is a balance. Okay. Internally, I think you're trying to figure this out. You're trying to figure out how you can have peace of mind through all these moments, right? I don't know about you, but during the full moon, your full moon, Aries, I thought, you know, that was a really heavy feeling. And I think it's not just because the moon was full in Aries with Chiron. Whoa, what do I, the I am presence in Aries, what do I need to heal with Chiron? That's a deep, you know, that's deep energy to begin with. But 2 days earlier, we had Mercury and Jupiter stop on the sky, right? They will retrograde, then they station, which means it's kind of stop or slow down or whatever to reverse, considering the way that the planets rotate and such. But then move forward. So it's inching forward. And then a couple days later, after inching in that stillness, we get this whew, full moon. So it felt like that. It felt this like dramatic pause. And I felt a little bit kind of like live wire, like my feelings were like these tingles on my body is kind of how it felt for me. I don't know how it felt for you, but in these moments, you feel almost a supernatural awareness that life is so much more than you realize and that you can only see a small part of it with the rods and cones of your eyes. That we're not sensing everything that there is, the heartbeat of the earth, for example, or the things in the quantum field that are happening, and the domino effect of life and energy, right? It was a big moment. It felt like that. I think for you, it was a pinnacle moment, a moment where you did face the things that have gone wrong and the things that you want to fix, the things that you want to do differently, better, the things you don't want to be afraid of anymore, and the things you need to let go of that aren't working properly anymore, because you need to get it back into balance, right? That's internal for you, and that's a deep knowing. That came, I think, with the full moon for you. So after that season that you've just let go of, your full moon, You can now dream this beautiful dream. You can now live with your heart a little bit more open because you're kind of aware of the fact that you don't have to fear your feelings. You don't have to fear things going wrong. You don't have to fear it. You just got to ride those waves. The Empress is about that. It's about growth. It's about knowing that inside we always have the capability, the vitality, because we're breathing, to birth something new into our lives. Once you figure this out about yourself, that you have this capability to be your best self, then you've really achieved and accomplished something. You come home to yourself, right? It's like you've mothered yourself through a nightmare and you soothed yourself, comforted yourself. And look at you, now you're okay. Six of Wands, Four of Wands. It's like you feel more comfortable now. Like life is something brand new to discover and you're ready for it. You're ready for the new dream. It doesn't have to be big or lofty. It can be simple things, right? Like, let's get real. You know, life isn't a soap opera filled with drama all the time. It can be something simple that you just really want to do, but you feel, maybe you're feeling differently now, like you've got a different energy, especially in your home, like feeling good in your home, feeling comfortable in your home, wanting to celebrate life again, and bring that feeling into your day-to-day life and into your relationships. And how and why? Because you choose it. Choices, Seven of Cups, Two of Cups in every relationship, your friendships, with your lover, your husband, your wife, whoever. Knight of Pentacles, practicing it every single day, taking life a step at a time. Unto everything there is a season. I can ride the waves, I can let go of the bad, and I can look forward to the good. But right now, I'm just going to breathe through the now, listen to the beat of my own heart, and appreciate that I'm alive. That's Scorpio, right? It's very sensual. I have so many choices, so many choices, and how to live my life. Now, for some of you, if you're looking for love and you're single, well, you're feeling really good, you're ready to bring somebody maybe into your home for a date, cook them a nice dinner. This is what I'm seeing here. It's like he's looking at all the dishes, like, what am I going to serve it in when I serve this beautiful meal? That's what I'm seeing. I'm seeing somebody having a date, bring somebody into the house, decorating for autumn. You know, unless you're on the in the southern hemisphere, which I think for you would be, what is that, spring? So then we have the Five of Swords. So things will come up maybe this week. Five of Swords. There may be an argument. People are really sensitive during Scorpio season, but it's really deep. So they're dealing with their own stuff. And no matter what happens, if somebody wants to take advantage, somebody tries to like car salesman you with something, or, you know, you're just going to be like, wow, they're going through some stuff. The way that they're trying to be really manipulative right now. You just let it slide. Let it go. It's okay. You know, because you can stay true to yourself. King of Cups. Stay true to yourself, Aries. Stay true to yourself. Keep your heart open. And with the Fool card, you know, take a leap of faith and just realize that you can start over every single day. That no matter what anybody says or does, it's your life and you can live it like you want. So don't let that stuff like get to you. That's what I'm seeing. It's like you've decided that your scary monsters are just big robotic craziness in your life and you can fix it. You can work on it. You don't have to be a robot. You can live through your heart. Follow the beat of your heart. You know, you don't have to orchestrate too much. You can just see what opportunities come along and take them as they come. Weigh them out on the scale and say, is this something I like in my life or no? Does this make, you know, the robot start going wild again? And when I say the robot, isn't that like how we can get, you know, I use the example driving home from work. You're driving home from work, you don't even remember how you got into your driveway, right? You got in your car, you end up in your driveway at home and you're like, I don't even remember driving. Automaton. you are trying to go a little deeper so you don't have to live like an automaton. You want to feel again. Scorpio season will help you do that. Because something is coming into your life, being birthed into your life, your daily life, your every single day life. It's beautiful. And it could be somebody, by the way, that you're very attracted to. The Empress also really symbolizes fertility. So a fertile life, a life of abundance. It could be abundance in finances, could be abundant love, but the Five of Swords is going to happen occasionally. It just is. And when it does, especially if this is a partner, they're just going through moods, okay? And if it's been a long while that they've been going through this mood, Scorpio season is an excellent season for therapy. It really, really is an excellent season for therapy. Let's look. Because you really want this relationship, if it's a relationship, which, by the way, is in the center of your reading today, the Two of Cups. You want it to go well. You want to have your heart open. You really want the friendship, the love, the family. You want to be seen and heard as you and loved, and you want it to go well. If this is about your mom, okay, Empress could be your mother, or mother figure, or just a prominent woman in your life. There may be argumentation, discord for some reason, and it could be over anything. It could be over your job, you know, or your daily habits, your diet, things you do every day, right? And just arguing with someone over it is like, well, I like poppy seed bagels. Well, I like everything bagels. They're so much better, and here's the reason why. It's like, okay, robot, robot, robot. Can we be a little more human here? Can we talk to each other with a little more heart? Right? It's that. So, you know what? Live your home. Live your life. Live your way of life exactly as you want to, Aries. You have all the choices in the world. Okay? Cook a nice meal for somebody, right? Take a risk. Take a chance at something brand new with the Fool card. Because with the Two of Cups in the middle here, it's like you just want to feel comfortable with people again. You want to get back out there. You want to bring more balance into your life. The four is a balance number. The six is a balance number. This is internal. You need your balance back. And with the Devil between them, this is like, I'm not going to take it anymore. You're pulling at the wrench and beating on the robot. No, I'm not going to robot through my life anymore. I'm not going to sleep too much. I'm not going to robot with people. You know, I'm going to be generous of spirit and more balanced and more creative, more vital, more confident, right? More willing to be seen, actually seen by people, not somewhere behind computers and phones and all the technology, roboting. No. I want to actually get face to face with people. I want to decorate my home together, cook dinner, do different things, add in some new things in my life that I haven't for quite a while, which has just gotten me a whole bunch of conflicted feelings and thoughts about the relationships in my life. You know what? I'm starting over. With my heart open. Willing to look at life as a blank slate. And that I can live it the way I want. And this is a very practical reading for you, Aries. It's like, what do you want to do every day to keep your life in balance? What do you want to put on those scales of time? What do you want to put on the scales? What do you want to do this season and add into your daily life? Four of Wands, Knight of Pentacles. This is about the day-to-day, how you live at home. What do you want to do? Because whatever it is, it should be centered around this beautiful way to have a relationship with anyone. Genuine relationship. By willing to be vulnerable. I'm willing to not bring too much baggage to the table. Just have your heart open. And visions of life beyond death is if your life has changed drastically, especially in 2021, if you've lost people, if you've let go of friends or walked away from a lover, anything like that, any death that's happened in your life, even if you actually lost someone and they did die, the truth of the matter is life still offers you season after season the chance to start again, to start new, and to redefine yourself in whatever way you deem as interesting and something that you really want to do that makes you feel alive again, right? You want to feel alive again, not robotic, just going through the motions in life. All right, Aries, well, I wish you kindness, reverence, and gratitude. Have a very happy Halloween.